You're an expert. I want to quickly show you through Pipedrive as fast as I possibly can today, just to get a quick understanding of what the system features are. So essentially what we're looking at here is a pipeline. Now we can have multiple pipelines. These can be for different parts of your business. In each pipeline is what we call stages, which are these sort of vertical lines here. The idea is that deals progress from left to right. Now a deal is basically a customer that you're working on to sell them something or a service or a product or whatever it may be that suits your business. It's very adaptable, can cover a lot of industries and a lot of different segments. So understand a deal as something that you're working on. Now we'll jump into an example deal. Now in here, we can leave notes, activities, these synchronize automatically to your calendar, or you can say only sync your calendar one way to Pipedrive. Heaps of flexible options there, but essentially to remind you to do things. We can also call from here. So in here, you can see that it's automatically pulled my phone number from the person field, basically the contact information. I can then transfer this phone call, create a phone call right now and send it to my iPhone 13 right now by hitting start the call, and my mobile will ring and I'll be connected to that customer. So super simple. From select browsers, you can also call directly from the browser. There is plenty of third-party plugins to, you know, sort of justify and for big volume companies do really fancy stuff. So there's heaps of good sort of technology in that sector. Really good for high volume companies, you know, solar and things like that, where you're making, you know, tens if not hundreds of calls per day from across multiple people. It will also put a log of that call in the system. You can also do recordings and all sorts of stuff as well, allocated into the deal. We can send an email from here, so automatically it'll populate my email address from the contact card. We can then do templates and all sorts of stuff. We can have default follow-up templates. It'll dynamically insert certain fields and things like that, you know. These can be pulled from custom fields down the left hand side. You know, if you had a tender ID, it could be, you know, a tender follow up, and we could insert that tender ID in here. We can also see, we can chuck in email signatures, attachments. We can also see when the email's tracked or if a link's clicked in the email, and that's all without asking for any read receipts or anything like that. So super low key, but very informative. We can also insert our proposed time. So we could say in here, essentially pick a time and date, and that will insert a link to my calendar where the person can book a time. So really, really handy, really good way to get, you know, your leads, I guess, a bit more warmed up. Now files, I always say Pipedrive is meant to be your source of truth. So, you know, contracts, agreements, NDAs, anything like that, anything that's applicable to this person and this deal should be uploaded here so that everybody can access that central point of truth. Now, don't forget we can macro crack down on permissions that certain people can only see certain things and can't see these emails and all sorts of stuff. So there's heaps of flexibility around that. We can build teams that can only see certain things. We can then have management levels that can see slightly higher than those. And then we can have super admins that can see kind of everything. So very, very flexible on that. We can even hide deals from people. We can hide just contact information from people, all sorts of stuff. So very, very flexible. Next one along is documents. Documents is basically, if you've got templates in sitting in Google Docs, for example, we can pull in that template, fill it out with the information from the deal, basically save a copy of that in the deal and email it to someone, for example, get a signature, whatever it may be that you required. And then it'll put that template back in Google Docs untouched. We can see when people open it, track all the clicks and everything like that as well. Invoicing, we can connect mainstream products like Xero, Myob. The Pipedrive Marketplace has a few different options in there. Super handy. If you do, say, for example, invoice out of Xero, you can create it. If this customer said, yep, let's go ahead, you could create the invoice from here, send the invoice. It basically pulls all the Xero data in real time into Pipedrive, into the particular invoice you're building. And then you could send that invoice and you could also mark that deal as won or lost. In the case of you sending an invoice, it would be likely won. So you would mark that deal as won. That would get out of your mainstream pipeline. Still completely visible in other areas, but it'll get it out of your focus area, and your next focus would be to the deals that are still open that aren't won or lost. If your market is lost, essentially we can create custom reasons why and start to see trends, you know, lost on finance or lost on price and things like that. You can then identify trends in reports that might say you're above market price or, you know, whatever it may be. So start to identify information that's, you know, happening in your business day to day that could be quite hard to, you know, keep track of if you're, you know, a larger organization. Even small businesses, you know, probably struggle with that as well. Down the left-hand side, all my contact information. mention. Now, we do have a smart contact data system where we can basically hit a button and it'll go around the internet and find, you know, LinkedIn profiles and all that sort of stuff. Same thing applies for organization. As you can see here, it's pulled in all our information about Media Booth, you know, current employees, you know, where we are, LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, all that sort of stuff as well. Following down, we can see the overview of how old that deal is. So in days, you can set alerts for 30 days and so, you know, create an activity. You can do all sorts of stuff in automation in part of Pipedrive, which is hugely powerful and something I won't go into today, but extremely powerful for setting follow-ups and reminders and all that sort of stuff on autopilot. So yeah, essentially really, really good tool. Here we've got Smart BCC. So if you don't want to connect your email up here, you can just BCC this email address directly for anything relating to this deal, or you can use the universal one and the system will do its best to synchronize that email to this particular deal. It's about 80-90% accurate. Occasionally you will have to, you know, manually attach an email trail to the deal and then it'll follow that in due course. If you do run a revenue, sort of a recurring revenue model in your business, you can set each customer to have an active revenue subscription in the system. That will basically track in reporting and give you output of what your, you know, monthly annual turnover will be based on your current active subscriptions. You can obviously set how many months it runs for, if it's only a 6-month term or whatever, completely adaptable and really good for reporting. If you do use Xero, here's an example of what Xero would look like as a snapshot. So we can see what's outstanding, what's been paid, anything like that when you connect each customer up to this. So really, really handy. Down the left-hand side, we basically have projects, which is a new feature. Essentially, once a deal's won, you can then delegate different tasks to people and sort of manage the actual completion of the job. So really quite a handy upcoming tool that is getting taken leaps and bounds at the moment, and I believe there's another overhaul coming for it shortly. Campaigns is very similar to something like MailChimp, SendGrid, Constant Contact, all those sorts of stuff. Essentially, it's a mass emailing system for sending newsletters, EDMs, all that sort of stuff, but it can be macro filtered down to who actually receives it. So it could be a specific word or filter or a custom field or something in a deal that has a keyword in it, or, you know, a relative reference that we can use, and we can send to specific people from that. So it has super macro sort of breakdown abilities, which is really, really handy. Mail, we could look at our normal inbox from here. So that would show all our incoming and outgoing mail. We could also use this for day-to-day email activities, even if they're outside of deals. You can essentially, you know, kind of stop using Outlook essentially if you wanted to. Activities is essentially an overview of our calendar. We can then filter down by what type of filters or what type of activities we've got to do for the day. And essentially from there, you know, see what we've got due for the day, mark them as done, move on to the next one. As you see there, when I mark something as done, because that deal's not hasn't been marked won or lost yet, it'll say, okay, great, when are we going to do the next activity to keep you on your toes and keep you following people up? So a really, really good little example there. Contacts, we can go through and see all our customer information. We can do all sorts of stuff. Insights, we can basically see how we're tracking in performance, you know, average deal values, the conversion rates, why they're being lost, you know, all sorts of stuff. So these are customizable dashboards that we can build multiple of those as well. We can also share this report. You know, this report can sit on a big TV in the boss's office or a management office, and essentially in real time update as new deals come in or won or lost or anything like that. So very, very cool, very flexible as well. We can then dive into our products as well. We can attach products to deals so that we can see the best performing products, the least performing products, etc. Pipedrive does have an external marketplace where people build apps and things like that to integrate with Pipedrive. Heaps of cool stuff in there now. So if you've got sort of a random sort of solution you need, there's a pretty good chance there's an app for it, kind of like apps for your smartphone. And then a bunch of other features. We've got automation, hugely powerful tool, won't break into it just now, but essentially you can create automation based on any sort of trigger and action within this system, send emails, do all sorts of stuff. So really, really cool feature. And then we can also import or export data. Importing data, we can import from, you know, major third-party CRMs if you're migrating from another system. Can absolutely help that in a lot of cases. So yeah, if you've got any questions, feel free to reach out. Thanks for your time.